How's everyone doing? My name is Mike, Christine's older brother, and the better looking sibling. When she came to me and told me that I had to give a speech, I gladly said, yes. I could finally embarrass her for getting to get back at her for forcing me to play Barbies with her when we were kids. Giving me ground rules. You're not supposed to rip off their clothes. A kiss, because apparently Barbies are not supposed to kiss another Barbie. And also getting back at her for throwing remote controllers at my face when we were 9. Because I told her I was the favorite one, I'm the only boy in the family, I'm the only one who continued the most honored, respected, most stereotypical Chinese last name. It's true, I'm the only boy in the family, so Colette, no pressure. My sister immediately afterwards gave me the ground rules for the speech. And this is verbatim. Okay, Mike, it's 3 to 5 minutes long. Joanne's first, you're next. And please do not, I repeat, do not embarrass the expletive out of me. I have to take off the swear words because there's kids here. If you ruin the most beautiful day of my life, I swear I will make Colette break up with you. You got that, Michael? Don't expletive with me. Of course, I probably mentioned. And what's the point? This is my one time to shine, my one chance of fame. And one time I can express myself and unleash all my frustration to my mom and dad for yelling at me for making her cry when I'm upstairs and she's downstairs. She's the princess, I swear. Of course, her reply was more expletives, and I'm not going to dabble into it because I'm a Christian man. I'm a man of good morals. God told me, just give my sister this one. You know, let her be. Come on. You're almost 30 years old, making almost 6 figures. You have a wonderful girlfriend. And you're probably going to be drunk while making the speech, so you have more things to worry about right now. Okay, I'll listen. I'll be the older brother, who, through all the turmoil and violence I experienced growing up with Christine, I truly do have a wonderful sister. Because I see it through Fred and Christine's relationship. My happiness my sister shows when Fred's around is amazing. She becomes Mother Teresa. A side I never really see growing up. And Fred is an amazing person himself. He's rich. He's rich. He doesn't do drugs. Rich. Can't handle his alcohol. He loves the Warriors and hates the Lakers. He's rich. And most importantly of all, he makes my sister happy. Fred, I'm very proud to call you my brother-in-law for the rest of my life because you make my sister happy. You have a wonderful family, a mom who makes the best Chinese food in the world, a sister who is probably related to Picasso, and a dad who plays point guard with a great crossover.
Yeah! Yeah!
Anyways, my baby sister is finally grown up. You are now someone's wife, someone's best friend, and someone's true love. I'm very proud of you, and even more proud of being your older brother. So remember, I'll always love you regardless of how many expletives you throw at me. Because I know deep down, it's said with love and compassion. And this is probably the first time I'm going to say this to her. But I love you, Zhou Chao. Congratulations. Thank you.
Take time to realize that I